Good morning, Golden Knights. Today is Monday, March 23rd. We are entering our second week of what seems to be our new normal. Local public schools are serving our communities from a distance platform, which is something very new to all of us. So I thought I would reach out to everyone in the community with a quick video, just an update. I appreciate everybody's feedback on my K-12s and the emails. But I think this might be a nice medium. I'm trying something new as well. As we're all doing distance work, we all have to pivot and try new things. So I'm doing that. This is my first video stream message. So I just want to give everybody an update. When this first happened, about a week and a half ago, we were on calls with the Commissioner of Education in New York and the Department of Health. And they had recommended that superintendents organize their school communities into four pillars. The first pillar is plant, the facilities, the buildings themselves. The second is the operations. Remember, folks, we are a very large nonprofit organization, and we have lots of operations that help keep us afloat. Even when the students and the teachers aren't here, we still have an obligation to keep our organization moving forward. So when we do return to our normal service, we can hit the ground running. So operations is the second pillar. The third pillar is the social and emotional aspect of what this crisis is doing to our students, our school community, our staff, all of us, myself included. And last and certainly not least, one of the flagship things that we do is academic support for our community, for our students. That's been impacted a whole lot. And I want to talk a little bit about what we've done here in Nanuet. So I'll take you all through each of these pillars briefly, just to give you an update, to talk first about the plant, the buildings themselves. We have closed all of our buildings. Last Monday and Tuesday, we called in all of our building and grounds and our custodial teams. I know I shared a few pictures with the PPE clothing, everybody kind of head to toe covered. All of our custodial workers did a wonderful job, amazing job. You couldn't walk through these buildings without, you know, smelling that bleach and the disinfectant. They did a wonderful job. And since then, we have had minimal access to our schools. Now, I know a lot of you were nervous from what I shared about the Bar Middle School on Friday the 13th. From that point on, any of you that were in that building, please just be vigilant in keeping your distance and keep a pulse on your own health. You were sort of officially precautionary quarantined through a non-direct case. But I want to let you all know that all of our buildings have been disinfected and cleaned, and only essential operations where someone would have to go into the school in the morning to just check the boilers and check some of those mechanical essentials. Those are the only people that have been on those campuses. So those schools are pristine at this point. I mean, we will continue to monitor those and hopefully hit it one more time before we invite everybody back to our school. So that's our facilities. And I have to give a shout out to Mr. Rudy Villani, who's been amazing. He's the director of our facilities, building and grounds. He and his team have done a wonderful job. Next is the operations, the business side of our school community. I have to say, prior to Friday the 13th, which was for all of us the last day that we had students and staff physically on campus, we amassed our pandemic response team, which is a wonderful group of professionals, a nice cross section of all different people in our school community, put our heads together. And one of the things that we did was we immediately ghosted and mirrored all of our operation software so that folks could work from home. So we've been doing that. Our operations, our business operations, everything, payroll, any of the essential things that we need to do, again, to keep our school community and our organization afloat, that's all being done. It's all being done remotely. So I want to say, you know, thank you to Ms. Ursula Carbone, Mr. Mario Spagnolo, for leading their teams and making sure that all of that essential software, this was a lot of the stuff that had to go into this, and we were prepared here in Nanuet. So I'm really proud of that pandemic team and how things have shaken out. The other piece to operations that I do want to bring to your attention that a lot of you don't know, we're spending a lot of time and energy right now on making sure that we're feeding our community, those folks that qualify for free and reduced lunch. We have food for you all. Right now, we're scheduled on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, and then we bundle Wednesday's food with Tuesday's distribution, and then we bundle Fridays with Thursdays. So a lot of school districts are doing this to limit the amount of bringing people in each day. We are on our second week of that. We served a large portion of our community last Thursday, and now we're here again today, pointing to my door, because I was out there with Miss Mary Ann Greger and our volunteers, and I want to thank all of our volunteers and our food service providers. I just went in and spoke with Rosa and the team. They are a wonderful group of people. They're all here. They're making food for our community. So thank you to them. We love them so much. We need them right now. That is one of our essential operations, is to distribute food. The other essential operation is childcare. All the superintendents in Rockland County are working right now with childcare services of Rockland County through the county leadership, Vicky Camarante, to try and put together a nice platform so that we can be of assistance to anybody in the medical field, anybody that needs childcare. Right now, Nanuet is part of that team. Nanuet is looking to donate a few of our classrooms, perhaps in GW Miller, where we can provide that kind of a service. So that's another operation piece that I think a lot of folks don't realize. We're spending a lot of time building that as well. And hopefully by the end of the week, we'll have that up and running. The superintendents in Rockland County under Mary G. Marsico we've been such a collegial group, and I couldn't have faced this mountainous challenge in my first year as superintendent without those friends. So it's been fantastic. Social and emotional. That's the third pillar. The social and emotional piece is real. What I'd like to say is very simple. Students and families, reach out. Reach out to our teachers via email. Reach out to our principals via email, and they will connect you with our wonderful fleet of professionals that are trained in this space. We have social workers, guidance counselors, school psychologists. All of those folks are working remotely each and every day. If you email them, if you reach out to them, they have resources for you. They can help talk you through this. There's a lot of good stuff online, but you may want to talk to a friendly face in your school community. One of our wonderful guidance counselors, school psychologists, social workers, they might be the best person for you. So please reach out to a teacher, reach out to a principal, and we can connect those dots for you. And last but certainly not least is our academic platform. We are on our second week, one of the few school districts that hit the ground running last Monday. So this is our second Monday in sort of virtual business. I have to say to the community, your feedback has been wonderful. It's been so encouraging to all of us. I share any of the positive emails that I receive from parents that are just patting us on the back for being prepared. Thank you all. What I would ask the entire community is to please, please be patient with us. We appreciate all of the accolades, but we realize that as schools, we are doing something different right now. We are building a plane in the air, and we're good at it, and we're going to do it, and we're going to meet our students where they are. But what we ask from our community, from our parents, because we know that you're at home working your job virtually and trying to teach your own kids, we know that this is a heavy lift. And so let's all be patient with each other. Let's give each other good feedback, some good ideas. But I just need you to know that this is a really important aspect of our teaching staff right now. Our principals, our district level teams are meeting in Zoom meetings constantly. Our goal is to elevate. Not one school district is 100% synchronized. I would caution parents to hearing, maybe a positive meme from another district and then reaching out to perhaps your teacher, your principal, and saying things like, why aren't we all doing this? I can assure you, I'm in touch with all the superintendents in the Lower Hudson Valley. No one is doing any one thing 100% of the time. We are all trying to try new things. We're doing PD sessions live. Each week, we're trying to all get out of our comfort zone and figure out how can we meet our community where they are? And that's a really, really tricky balance to strike. So we're going to keep doing this as long as we're out. We're going to continue to elevate as Nanuet always does. I assure you, all four of these pillars are really important to all of us. They're on my daily mission list. So as we say, in our school right now, we have a lot of internal emails going around. You know, I try to end every single email with the one word, together. We are in this together. Nanuet always does things like no other school community. We are a small school community, small town, big heart. This is the time to show that we are together. We have each other's backs, and we will get through this. And I can't wait to stand outside that flagpole on that first day back to watch all the kids come off the buses, because, man, I miss them. I miss the energy. You know, this is not school. What we're trying to do is not school. What we're trained in is we're trained in being with students. We're trained with collegial connections. That's the brilliance in public schools, is being in the environment of learning, social, emotional learning, academic learning. It happens in a fluid format in school in real time. And that's been stripped of us right now. So we're trying to do something different. And I have all the confidence in the world that our teams can do that. So be safe, Knights. Thank you for listening. Thank you for staying plugged in. And I will talk to you all soon. Go Golden Knights.